love them, because the Bible says love your enemies, pray for those who persecute you. You got to do that. You know, the Christian life calls us to be. You know, it's in Romans 12:1, it says, let me read that to you. In Romans 12:1, it says, I urge you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, to enter by as a living and holy sacrifice, which is your spiritual service. And do not be conformed to this world, this is verse 2, but ye be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what the will of God is, that which is good and acceptable and pure. The normal thing to do with your life is to live it as a sacrifice. What that means is, I'm going to do whatever I know that I have to do that's best for you. Whether you want it or not, I'm going to do it. If you don't like it, want to slap me, I'm still going to keep doing what God's telling me is best for you. I'm just going to do it. Why? Because I'm a living sacrifice. That's what I'm supposed to be toward one another. That's what we have to do. If we can't love each other here, guess what? Nobody else is going to come through that door. You see what I'm saying? They're just not going to come. They're not going to come a place where everybody's yang-yang one another. They're just not going to do it. They get enough of that at home. They want to come here and find the peace of God. Amen? And they want that to happen. And so here's what we need to do. We need to make sure that we know we have the promise of eternal life. Do you know you've got that? You had that before they invented the wheel. You had that before they came up and sliced bread. You got the best thing in the world. And you came to God and received from Him the promise of eternal life when you gave yourself unto His Lordship. You know, I did that when I was 17. I don't have any regrets whatsoever about giving my life to God through Christ. And I wasn't in the church when I got saved. I was in a citywide crusade in the Civic Center in Winter Roberts, Georgia. And I was sitting on the very back row next to the door because I was still running. But I couldn't get up and leave that night. God got a hold of me and says, you're coming to me. So I got up from the very back row in this Civic Center, walked all the way down to the front and stood there. Waited to see what was going to happen. This old man, whose name I do not know, but his face I remember, he told me what it really meant to have a relationship with God and Christ. And he says, the good thing about that, if you receive this, the day you die, you go, we don't want you to die today, but you go to heaven when you die. He said, do you want this in your life? I said, yes, I do. He prayed over me, and I prayed, and I walked away knowing that I knew Jesus. He didn't tell me a whole lot. He just said, if you make this decision, when you die, you'll go to heaven. There's a whole lot of living between when he said that. I was 17. I'm 66 now. There's a whole lot of living between that. I ain't died yet. But I know this. He told me the truth. When I die, you get to go to heaven. How did I know that? Because he promised me eternal life. We just read that. He may have not even known that verse, but he knew the truth of it. That's what he told me. And that very same night, we got in the car. We were leaving the Civic Center. We pulled out on Watson Boulevard. This black GTO pulled up beside us. It was Tommy Taylor. He says, where y'all been? I said, Tommy, we've just been to the Civic Center, and I just got saved. He says, I need that too. We went to the only church. We knew where it was. We went, rode down Watson Boulevard to Central Baptist Church, and we pulled into the parking lot. Only church that anybody ever knew that any time during the day or night, you could walk in there to their altar or sit in their pew, whatever, to pray. But Bobby, Chris, and I, we took Tommy in there, and we knew she hadn't been saved very long, and I just got saved. But you know what we had the joy of doing? We had the joy of leading Tommy to Christ. It just starts. It's a great life. It went from earthly pain to heavenly gain. What they did. I can't believe that. I didn't cry over their death because I know they had received the promise from God that they had eternal life. And he's not a man that he should lie. And so I know they just departed. I'll get to catch up with them one day. Why? Because the promises of God are true. And this promise about eternal life, it ought to make the difference in your life that God is going to work everything out for your good. You may not understand what's going on, but trust me. It may seem like the roof is fixing to fall out of the house, but trust me. It may seem like the floor is about to fall out from under you, but trust him. He knows what he's doing. He's in control of the Russian-Ukraine thing going on over there. He's in control of Israel. And don't ever go against Israel, because God says, I got them. They're my chosen people. But because the Jews didn't receive him like God intended for them to, they rebelled against him, we got to come into the family. Amen. When I meet somebody and I say, hey, I want you to come to Mill Creek Baptist, I'm Jewish, I said, hey, thanks a lot. You're the foundation of my faith. Why don't you come the rest of the way and know Jesus? Well, they're the foundation of our faith. Do you know that? When someone tells you that, say, hey, thanks so much. Just come on to the faith and you'll have this promise of what? Eternal life. That ought to wake people up when you start talking about the gift that you have in eternal life. And the thing that I tell folks is, listen, I don't want to be in heaven without you. Don't you want to hear about Jesus? Just let them know you care about them and start sharing the promise of eternal life. That makes us a witness. Jesus said to his disciples, go into all the world. When you step out there, you walk into your house or you stop by and Sonic can get a Route 44 Suite T, the person who comes to your car, guess what? That's your mission. You go to Kroger and you go to the line, that cashier's your mission field. Because they charge pastors taxes on both sides, I do a job to pay my taxes so I can live off the salary the church gives me. Well, three Thursdays ago, I delivered to a bagel shop with a magazine that I delivered, and I handed a lady my card and said, listen, I'd love you to come and worship with us. Guess what she did? She showed up 3 weeks later, and she brought someone with her, and they both enjoyed being here. We had an anointing for one of our members, and they came down to pray with us over that person, and the lady's name was Michelle. She says, I need to be anointed too. First time here, she knew that there was something that happened for her life if she walked out there, and so we got to anoint her too. And so we're asking God to just strengthen both of them as they walk in the Lord. Isn't that great? They know the promise in James chapter 5, that says if there's any among you that's sick, let them call upon the elders of the church, let them lay their hands and anoint you with oil, and the prayer of a righteous man will avail much. So we pray for our cleansing, we lay our hands on, and we go do it. Why? That's the promise of God. That he'll make a difference in their life when they come and seek that anointing that God has for them. Amen? I've got to tell you, when you look to the Word of God, it says do something, do it. It says don't do it, just don't do it. And guess what? You'll have such a relationship with God, you'll be walking in His grace. His love, His mercy, His kindness, and His peace. Nothing can shake you. A person who stands on the rock, who is Jesus, the world cannot shake you. Did you know that? I can tell you, someone came in that door right now and said, recant of your faith or die. Guess what? I'm going to die. Because I'm not going to let that person tell me the promises of God. That man shoots me, guess what? God just worked out something for my good. I just got to see Jesus. That's exciting, amen?
I'm telling you.
Whatever happens in your life, look for the good that God has in it. Amen? Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, I thank you for your word. I thank you for the wonderful promises that are there. Lord, as we read the word, it just don't really rock our world, rock our mind. There's just such an understanding of how, as we read your word, how awesome you are, God. There's nothing or no one or anything created or not that compares to you. God, we thank you that you are a God of truth, that you can be trusted. We thank you that your promises are steadfast and sure. We thank you that as we stand on Jesus, the rock of our salvation, that whatever happens in this world will not shake us because of your promise, that you will work all things together for our good. And Lord, if we believe that about ourselves, we can believe about that our brothers and sisters. That's why I could say I didn't grieve when my parents passed away, God. Because I trusted your word, that they had come to you, and you had given them the promise of eternal life. And I look forward to seeing them again one day, because you've given me the promise of eternal life. Let this promise that we have make a difference in our lives as we look toward the